Welcome back, guys. You're still hanging out with Faye. Now, right now, we're getting into the Youth Talk segment. This is the one and only segment where we basically break down all the things that you've either heard about or you want to talk about. So if you want to contribute on this topic, all you have to do is go on to Twitter, that is at PfizerFats, at Urban TV, or Platform 256 on Facebook, and let us know all your thoughts. Now, one interesting thing has always happened is that when the bigger percentage is from the UNEB syllabus, like me, we've all been through the UNEB syllabus, now, but there are so many people out there who are from the Cambridge syllabus. If you've been to international schools or to those dope schools that everyone fears to go, those are the ones that use the Cambridge syllabus. Now, the Cambridge syllabus is basically where you study specifically what you want and concentrate only and only on, that. If you want videography, Waringa Farouk, that's the only thing you're going to do. Okay, then you go and do your paper. But hey, we sat down with students of HANA International because they do both syllabuses and we wanted to find out from each side which is better, which is more beneficial. Anyway, we have a guest host, Ranel. He basically sat down with them and got all their opinions and we broke down finally which is better. Anyway, check this out. When we come back, we have so much more.
Hi guys, we're still here at HANA International School in Sanji, and I'm here chilling with the cool guys like Faye had told you. But I'm here to ask them a simple question about the two curriculums that they have at HANA International. I want you guys to tell me something. Mwina, UNEB and Cambridge. Yeah, is everyone doing UNEB or is someone doing Cambridge?
I do Cambridge.
You do Cambridge. So I want you to tell me briefly, what do you think Cambridge is better than UNEB, or why do you think it was a better option than UNEB?
My name is Danny Williams. I feel like Cambridge is a better option than UNEB because it's self-driven. When a student is self-driven, he knows what to do, and then he cares about what he's doing because they don't have to push him for it. But then in UNEB side, the teacher gives everything to the student to do. Why? Us, they just tell us, they give us not only the basics, they give us the basic, but then they're expecting too much from us. So it just makes us work harder, look for, that's why you see in Cambridge, that's why they permit students to be on Wi-Fi, have their phones, have their computers, because we work 24/7, you know, because it helps, it makes our brain to be used to the outside world. So when we get there, we know what to do. Okay. Thank you.
To me, according to the current Uganda, the way I look at it, according to what's operating inside, because when you see the road constructions, the engineers are working there. They're Chinese, they're guys from abroad. And those same people, it's very hard to find a Ugandan who is an engineer on such
locations. But they didn't study Cambridge.
But they didn't study Cambridge. What does it imply? These people, Uganda, okay, believes in people who are from abroad. In the same spirit, you may find people from abroad, they also believe people who are from other countries.
But the people that give contracts to those Chinese, yeah, and Ugandan.
Yeah, but then, now what do I bring in? If you're doing a Cambridge syllabus, why I say it's more better and helpful, if you're doing a Cambridge syllabus, when you go abroad with that certificate coming from Cambridge, because remember the exams are done marked from UK and everything. But then, if you go with your certificate having Cambridge, it's very easier for you, because now we already have even some students of us who are in universities like in Harvard studying there. But then, if you're
from HANA,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. But then if you did UNEB and then you are going that side, it's very, very complicated for you to get some capacity of doing
really?
Something from there.
What's your take?
I think UNEB and Cambridge, those are two big things, right? Sometimes it's according to the two people that
Would you rather UNEB or Cambridge?
Think UNEB. I think it gives out more of the lifestyle, you know. You have to suffer to get something that you want.
I personally, I would prefer Cambridge. I'll be sorry to relate this to political affairs in the country. Due to the job opportunities in Uganda, really UNEB doesn't pertain to the job opportunities to Uganda. That's why I prefer doing Cambridge, then you go abroad. And that's why people are just doing brain drain.
According to me, I prefer UNEB just because, like, we are in Uganda and these guys who are giving us jobs, they also did UNEB. They did UNEB. Like, it's UNEB developing the whole system, everything. I've never seen a lawyer who did Cambridge and is in a Ugandan court. Personally, a person like me who wants to become a lawyer, I have to get examples of role models here.
I'm okay with Cambridge because Cambridge is all about learning what you know you don't waste time. Like in UNEB, they'll make you do physics and chemistry.
But you're doing
UNEB. No, like when you don't know it.
I prefer UNEB because, like, in UNEB, you're given some time to, like, pick, like, the subjects you can do when you're in A-level. But if it's Cambridge, what I've heard, you just go straight and pick the subjects you can do. And in most cases, it's hard for some people to go abroad because it's not that easy, like, moving to these African countries. And if you're getting a job from Uganda, you need Uganda documents, not the Cambridge documents.
I would prefer Cambridge because if I have the certificate from Cambridge, my brain is open for any university in this world. I think that's from me. Prefer Cambridge.
All right, thank you guys for your time. We're still here at HANA International. We've been discussing about, of course, the curriculum, and everyone has given their opinion. So let us know what you think about the topic on our social handles. Of course, Urban TV on Twitter. Facebook is Platform 256. And from me and the entire team, Pfizer, we out.
Alright guys, welcome back. It is Youth Talk. You're hanging out with me, Faiz. And of course, when you see me right here, you know I'm here to hook you up with some of the latest flicks in town. And hey, for the guys out there who love animations, Ugly Doll is here. In a world where everyone is looking for imperfection, this movie celebrates all our imperfections. Every time you think you're not perfect, this one is all for you guys. So you need to watch this one. It's already out. It's freshly out. So man, it's about time you get that popcorn, grab that bae and watch this movie. And the second one is The Last Black Man from San Francisco. Now this one is a very interesting one. If you're one who's out there always looking for inspirational movies that are celebrating culture, celebrating home, roots where you come from, this one is perfect for you. It's about two brothers who are struggling to tie back to their hometown and also redefine their lives. So you have to watch this one. My favorite in this list is Maleficent. If you guys are a fan of Angelina Jolie, it's been a while, man. We've only seen her in news struggling with Brad Pitt, but hey, it's time she get back in the movies. Disney is bringing her back in Maleficent, Mistress of the Evil. This is the second one. You guys need to watch this one because it's going to be dope. It's fun. It is even bigger and better. Man, Maleficent comes out in October, but Ugly Doll is already out. And Last Black Man also comes out in June, so you need to hook yourself up. Anyways, check out these top three trailers. When we come back, we have so much more. Keep it locked.
Every year, millions of dolls are created, perfectly designed to bring joy to people everywhere. But what happens to the dolls who aren't so perfect?
Welcome to Uglyville, friend.
Wake up, Moxie.
Woo! I've always believed the big world is real. I know I'll find the perfect kid for me, but I'm starting to wonder, with no evidence, no proof, what if it's not true?
Find your own truth.
Come on! Wow. Guys, what if this is the way to the big world?
How do we get up there?
Yeah. Anytime now, guys.
What's perfection?
Who is that?
That's Lou. He's the most perfect one here.
Let me break it down.
Welcome to the Institute of Perfection, where only the best will meet their perfect human match.
You're an engineer / model.
My accessories will make me different.
You're a lawyer / model.
I'm an individual, exactly like the rest of you.
You're not a model.
Data does not compute.
Remember the story of an evil witch.
When I look out my window.
And the princess she cursed to sleep forever.
Many sights to see.
The story became legend.
And when I look in.
But this is no fairy tale.
So many different.
There are many who prey on the innocent. I'm sure your kind would agree. If I didn't know better, I'd say you were making a threat.
Well, do you?
Do I what?
Know better.
What have you done?
Let's be the season of the witch. Let's be the season of the witch.
these canals in the San Francisco they never knew existed. This is our home.
Come back to the old house.
What if it's empty?
What if we just peeked inside?
We could throw parties. You could put on one of your plays. We could yell.
Where is this house?
Our old house.
That's not your old house, and that's not your neighborhood.
Hey, if you're going to San Francisco, be sure to wear flowers in your hair.
Maybe he's right.
What if we shouldn't be here?
We should be here more.
Some millionaire.
To leave is not your loss. It's San Francisco.
How much longer we can keep doing this?
But I'm not leaving. I'm the last one left.
I'm with you, bro.